çekmiş hep nine. Pınarlardan su doldurur eminem. Mavi boncuk takışına ölürüm Türkiye'm, ölürüm Türkiye'm, ölürüm Türkiye'm. Mavi boncuk takışına ölürüm Türkiye'm.
is what you came for. Lightning strikes every time she moves, and everybody's watching her, but she's looking at you.
This is what you can. Welcome back to day six of Olympic Channel's live stream of the 13th European Youth Olympic Festival in Erzurum, Turkey. I'm Tom Kirkland, taking you down to the end here of what has been a wild and crazy ride. As expected, we are enjoying the crash and burn nature of short track speed skating. Boys and girls, ages 14 to 18 here in the Yenisei ice rink. A lot of red flags. You see a whole lot of support for the Turkish boy who is in the final coming up on the boys' side after the girls' B final and then the A final when they award the medals on the girls' side. But you'll see all the flags in the crowd for Turkey's Karagol, who will have a shot at a medal coming up. But in the meantime, we have been treated to what we expected, some surprises, but really form following, particularly on the women's side, the girls following the lead of the absolutely most dominant so far here. That is the work of the Russian Roskosova, who has won gold in the 500 and 1500 already. In the girls' A final, it'll be very interesting. We'll break that down shortly, but right now it's the girls' B final, where we're looking for, there you see some of the crowd hanging around now with a lot to look forward to in the boys' final. And now the girls' B final to determine the bottom end of the girls' competition. Position one is where the form would come from. Georgie Dalrymple just beaten out, just missed qualifying for the final. Again, it's eight laps. Nobody advances. This is it. This is the last race here for these girls, except for the much anticipated 3,000 meter mixed event coming up after. In the meantime, there they go. As we've seen early on, it's a little bit of positioning. Girls want to stay upright and not suffer an early fall. And then at about the second or third, fourth lap, you see if there's a burst to come, somebody's going to try to get out and steal it or get out and get in better position. That would be the time. There goes Albert and Levesque into the lead. Two girls from the Netherlands chasing, but very tight. You would expect Dalrymple, based on her work earlier, came in second to Roskosova in the 500 meters. You expect her to make a move. But it's all about who has it here on this day. And there goes Levesque trying to get in position, battling with Julie Albert from Romania. And now the field is tightened up, and here comes Georgie Dalrymple on the outside, number 13, in the familiar Netherlands orange, starting to pull away, two laps to go. This will feel a little better after just barely missing out on the final. Georgie Dalrymple absolutely throwing down here, easily winning the girls' B final. Might feel a little hard done, a little robbed by the results in the semifinal, but again, that's the nature of this discipline and these races. You want to be fast and you want to have good tactics, but there's luck involved, and you just never know lap to lap what's going to happen. A bump here, a slip there. Peter Murphy took an inadvertent elbow to the head as he was looking around to make a move and just didn't have it at the end. Now the girls' final. moments away. Poland and Russia going head-to-head. Raskasova and Boytsova from Russia. Stornowska and Markowitz from Poland. Three of the four will podium. And clearly, based on form so far this week in Erzurum, Raskasova would be the one to follow. Looking for her third gold medal.
Ladies and gentlemen, the final 1,000 meter for ladies.
Here we go. Can anybody catch Raskasova? Certainly Boytsova, her countrywoman, knows her well. They skated 1-2 in the semis, breezing through.
On start position 3, Kamila Stormowska.
Stormowska and Markowitz from Poland.
And on start position 4, Patricia Markiewicz.
Clearly a long sporting history, many battles between these two nations. And the heartbreak is one of these four elite athletes will not podium. One of them is going to be disappointed, maybe more if they don't finish where they expected to. Again, everyone's chasing Vera Raskasova, number 20, lane one, false start. Little bit of an early jump from Stormowska. One more false start for her and she'll be out. Don't anticipate that. Again, first lap or so, first there, everyone, you just want to stay up and size up the field. Teamwork involved, especially here. Two Polish, two Russian short track skaters, and we'll wait to see how it all breaks down. This is all strategy at this point. As they look around, at some point you're going to see number 20, if form follows. We've watched her throughout the day. At some point, Vera Raskasova is just going to make a move. At this point, the leaders trying to hold her back and, you know, maybe lock her down a little bit. And there they go. It is on now. Gold, silver, and bronze on the line. Three out of the four will podium. Polish girls in good position, but look out for Raskasova. Four laps. There goes Raskasova. Sizing it up. You anticipate the move coming, and from the back comes Raskasova's teammate, Boytsova. At this point, though, Stormowska in front. Here goes Raskasova. Can she find a way? Can she get the third at this point? It has to be right now. And she'll only silver. A great race from Kamila Stormowska of Poland. Big upset here. And you could see early on the Polish strategy of they slowed it down. They went 1-2. They kept Raskasova in check. Didn't let her get off to her usual burst. Stormowska holding on in the lead position. And a late push by the favorite, looking for her third gold. Just not quite enough. this point. Stomowska feeling like she had it and just barely holds off the late push from Ruskozova. And just to give you an indication of how the Polish girls slowed things down, that's a full 8 seconds, 7 seconds and change slower than what Ruskozova skated in the semifinal. 8 seconds. Incredible that they kept her back, held her back, and the burst just wasn't quite enough. So gold and bronze for Poland, and Russia's Ruskozova grabs a silver to go with her two golds already, and now the familiar flags draped over the shoulders.
Ladies and gentlemen, the award presentation.
And they go right to
the awards. Will be presented
the awards.
By assistant referee Peter De Kimper.
Wondering what's going through the mind of Vera Ruskozova.
On the third place, representing Poland, Patricia Markiewicz.
Acknowledging the crowd. Again, the crowd building for the boys' final, which will feature
the
Turkish short track speed skater.
Ruskozova.
Incredible work in Erzurum. Two golds and a silver. And a lesson learned maybe in the final here, but Stomowska is your gold medal winner. Surprise in the girls' 1,000-meter short track speed skating event here at the European Youth Olympic Festival in Turkey. Keep an eye on these names. And gather together picture. Maybe not for PyeongChang 2018, but certainly Beijing 2022. Now the stage is set. After the girls put on a tremendous show, it's the boys coming up with their B final, followed by the A final, and the girls getting a chance to pose for the cameras and our camera right there. It's a happy group. What a great week. The short track speed skating event continuing to be a crowd pleaser. No injuries that we know of, nothing crazy, some crashes, that's to be expected now. The boys, 1,000-meter B final. Ivliev, Geray, Peter Murphy, who has already won a gold and a silver in the 500 and the 1,500. Perhaps a tactical mistake, beaten out by certainly the star, the budding star, the guy, the young man who will be the local hero as we get ready for the A final. But now we'll keep an eye on the boys' B final.
Start position one, Konstantin Ivliev.
Erkekler 1000 metre final anda birinci başlangıç noktasında Konstantin Ivliev Rusya'yı temsil ediyor.
On start position two, Augustin Geray.
İkinci başlangıç noktasında Lüksemburglu yarışmacı Agustin Geray.
Start position three, Peter Murphy.
Üçüncü başlangıç noktasında Lüksemburg'u temsil eden Peter Murphy.
And start position four, Christian Giska.
Dördüncü başlangıç.
A pair of medalists from earlier events, so this a very classy B final. Ivliev from Russia, silver behind Murphy in the 1500 meter. Murphy, silver behind man you'll see coming up in the 1,000-meter final. Romanovskis. We'll see if Murphy wants to make a statement here after maybe making a mistake and allowing the Turkish skater to sneak in ahead of him and qualify for the final. There goes Murphy. He is trying to pour it on right here. I think taking out some frustration. He fully expected to be skating in the next race. He has already blown away the field. You might see a late push from Konstantin Ivliev, who should be stronger later in this race, a 1,500-meter silver medalist. But Murphy won the 15, so he has plenty in his tank. Four laps to go. He went out and just took it. I had a feeling that his frustration would be taken out on the field here. Two laps. Murphy, Guerre making a push, making a bit of a push. The two Luxembourg skaters making, and there goes Guerre all the way around. So indeed, Guerre rallies to take Murphy down. Not sure it really matters to Murphy. He's more about the podiums than he is about the B finals. Murphy tried to just go steal it right away. Sometimes there's strategy involved with teammates. And now you see the crowd, you hear the crowd getting ready for the final, much anticipated final coming up here. The crowd anticipating perhaps a medal performance from Hazar Karagol from Turkey. There you see him, number 126 at the bottom of your screen. Alexei Samakhin figures to battle. Diane Cellier from France will be there. And Romanoskis has already won a gold in the 500 meter as they line up. There he is, Karagol, making a clever move about halfway through, a little past halfway through. Took the favorite Peter Murphy, I believe, by a little bit of a surprise. Maybe Murphy thought he could reel him in, but Karagol showed tremendous stamina, holding on to just take out the favorite. And now Karagol comes in this boys' A final. The fastest semifinalist, Cellier from France, fastest. Romanoskis, the second fastest. Samakhin from Russia, third, and Karagol, fourth. But it doesn't matter at this point. They're all skating for three podium spots. We've already seen Karagol use tactics and an early burst to take a spot here in the boys' 1,000-meter short track speed skating final. And you'll hear the crowd. Karagol will start on the fourth. I'll just lay out and let you listen to the reaction. It's about to get loud.
On start position two, Salvius Romanoskis.
İkinci başlangıç noktasında Litvanyalı Salvius Romanoskis.
It's your favorite.
On start position three, Alexei Simakhin.
Simakhin could challenge, but here's the favorite.
And on start position four, representing Turkey, Hazar Karagol.
If not the race favorite, certainly the crowd favorite. And I gotta believe that extra adrenaline carried him into the finals. We'll see if he can pull something else forward in this one. Again, the one to watch, Romanoskis.
Ready.
opportunity of his young lifetime right here for Karagol from Turkey.
European Youth Olympic Festival with DNA Sellier, Salfios Ramanauskas, Alexis Simenkina, Hassar Karagol.
See where Karagol makes his move, just lurking on the outside. As all four size the field up, they better not let Ramanauskas get out there. Looking for his second gold of the European Youth Olympic Festival here in Erzurum. Simakin making his move, and there goes Ramanauskas. And when will Karagol go? Because then Sellier's there, five laps, plenty of time. Again, it's short track, stay tuned. Any move could change the finish. There goes Sellier. And in the inside, can Karagol make something happen on the outside? Sellier trying to steal it. Karagol now in silver medal position.
107, DNA Sellier stays.
Samakin falling back, and the favorite Ramanauskas way behind at this point. There they go. It's for first. Hang on. Can Karagol steal it? Oh, problem behind. 1-2 right here.
And the finish.
Sellier and a silver for Karagol.
The second place for Hassar Karagol.
And there's
the third place for Alexei Simakin. And the fourth place.
There's more. More trouble. We'll have to see the replay, see what took down the favorite, Ramanauskas, and who got up to get the bronze. And you see all the hugs. What a race. What a performance. Handling the pressure of being the hometown favorite. Hazar Karagol will always remember the move he made to surprise Peter Murphy in the semifinals. And there he goes. His moment in the sun. There was a little bit of a storming of the ice that they quickly controlled, but some fans wanting to congratulate him a little early. Tremendous performance. And at the top, Diane Sellier of France. Maybe not the one people thought would be at the top of the podium, but there he is, surviving the heavy traffic. And a penalty will go to the 500-meter gold medalist, Ramanauskas. Won't matter, won't affect the ending. Alexei Samakin will get third. Sellier, final time, 4 seconds slower than his semifinal. There you go. How close is it at the top? And then after the fall, Semakin got up, crossed the line, and we'll see it now. We'll see what happened to Ramanauskas and Semakin later. But once again, Karagol, about halfway through, started to make a move. The final two laps, he poured it on and pushed Sellier. Sellier ran away early, and there goes Karagol. And you'll see behind, there's the wipeout. Just as Ramanauskas made his push, there they go in the back, you see. At this point, Karagol trying to push and sneak inside. Good enough for silver. Gold to Sellier of France. And obviously, the fans at the Yenisheer Ice Rink, very, very happy. Something all of them will remember. Up and coming winter athletics country, putting on a tremendous show, and the reviews for Erzurum and the country of Turkey for their staging of the Winter Youth Olympic Festival has been across the board. Very complimentary. from the beginning when the venues were praised as being Olympics ready. And the execution of the games, which is always difficult, requires so much organization, the volunteers and all of the support staff. The athletes have been wonderful. There is Samakin. Get third. Wait till you hear this applause right here.
Ladies and gentlemen, on the second place, representing Turkey, Hasar Karagol.
Ve Türkiye tekrar pazar günü gel.
And on the first place, representing France, Diane Sellier.
Ve birinci olan
France. Diane Sellier. Incredible performance, beating some of the class in the sport here in Europe. All three, much to be proud of. We're not done. If you think this was exciting, you want to stick around for the mixed 3,000-meter relay. Turkey is in the A final, so the crowd will be electric. 3,000 meters long race. Relay, mixed, all kinds of elements. So stay tuned. What a moment for all three there. Certainly, Karagol will never forget this week and certainly this day at the Yenisher Ice Rink in Erzurum, and gives him a lot to build on. And I don't think that leaders will be surprised with a move he makes late in a race anymore. They'll have their eye on him. You can only imagine what his day will be like.
And ladies and gentlemen, with this final, we have completed the 1,000-meter individual program. We now have a resurface of the ice, and we continue the competition at 14:42 with the finals of the relay. 14:42.
They just announced about a 20-minute delay, which is normal. They will resurface the ice, and you want to make sure you check back with us in about 15 minutes' time as we prepare for the 3,000-meter short track speed skating mixed relay. A lot of elements here, and this figures to get crazy. Hope you're enjoying it. Tom Kirkland bringing this to you, Olympic Channel live stream of the 13th Youth Olympic Festival in Erzurum. The Yenisher Ice Rink has provided much drama and incredible enthusiasm from the home group as their guy, Karagol, grabs the silver in the men's 1,000-meter. Reminder, you're watching this short track speed skating final day, part of our Olympic Channel live stream of the 13th European Youth Olympic Festival in Erzurum. Also available on YouTube and on our Facebook page. Keep coming back to the Facebook page. A lot of good stuff there. Tom Kirkland stepping aside. We'll talk to you again in about 15 minutes' time for the wild and crazy 3,000-meter mixed relay final.
bakışına ölürüm Türkiye'm, ölürüm Türkiye'm, ölürüm Türkiye'm, hey. Irmağının akışına ölürüm Türkiye'm, ölürüm Türkiye'm, ölürüm Türkiye'm, hey, hey, hey. Irmağının akışına ölürüm Türkiye'm, ölürüm Türkiye'm, ölürüm Türkiye'm, hey, hey, hey.
The mind was gonna blow, but when I was in the south, go low, everybody go low. Cause you want me, she don't want a cocoa. So I made it single back, like she want my loco. And I got a Merc, I got a Volvo. Used to have a black, but it's a Volvo. Now everywhere I go, people want a photo. I can make a honey, give away a long solo. And I stay show, yo, you're in the high road. All the girls like,
me up in the Benz. I like cruising around the West End.
Asırlardır kır atımı suladım. Irmağının akışına ölürüm Türkiye'm, ölürüm Türkiye'm, ölürüm Türkiye'm. Irmağının akışına ölürüm Türkiye'm, ölürüm Türkiye'm, ölürüm Türkiye'm. Çekmiş hep ninem, pınarlardan su doldurur eminem. Mavi boncuk takışına ölürüm Türkiye'm, ölürüm Türkiye'm, ölürüm Türkiye'm. Hey. Mavi boncuk takışına ölürüm Türkiye'm, ölürüm Türkiye'm, ölürüm Türkiye'm. Hey hey hey hey hey. Mavi boncuk takışına ölürüm Türkiye'm, ölürüm Türkiye'm, ölürüm Türkiye'm.
Welcome back to the Yenisher Ice Rink. Tom Kirkland here, Olympic Channel live streaming day six as we wrap it up. 13th European Youth Olympic Festival in Erzurum, Turkey. Hope you've enjoyed so far the men's 1,000-meter heats, quarters, semis, and final. Same with the women. And now it's a combination as we get ready for the B final of the mixed 3,000-meter short track final. Each team will feature a pair of girls and a pair of boys. The B, Romania, Albert, Guidro, Nedelia, and Stash, Belarus, Demiratsky, Hapan, Krasnova, and Seleskina, Ukraine, Iofen, Hyochin, Makovetska, and Varopeva, Czech Republic, Bikonova, Fikas, Fiferova, and Sespal. And there we go.
And we have started with the B final.
The team women starting out.
Is Romania. With green caps is Belarus. With blue, Ukraine. And the white caps.
And the handoff with the push. This is, this will get wild here. So far, it is Romania out in front. Ukraine pressing.
Romania is in leading position.
The men pushing off
Albert, Guidro,
to the women.
Cosmin, Yonut, Nedeli, and Attila Ispansash.
You see in the inner portion, the handoff. They get up to speed inside of the little markers, and they jump out and await the touch and the push. 22 laps to go, so settle down. Although if you're used to this, you know that at any moment things can unwind, I'll say. And that unwinding can be a somewhat scary and painful proposition on the ice with collisions and falls. But at this point, a clean race, that's what we hope for. We're standing by for just about anything because it is short track. The Romanians off in great form. So much strategy here. Multiple handoffs between the four involved. Romania was the best of the B final qualifiers, which just means they were close to the A final, but here they are. And if you don't think this means much, you can imagine the battles with your foes over the years and the country rivalries, and this matters a great deal. Anytime these world-class athletes are competing, but even more so when it's a team involved.
Well, we have 12 laps to go on lap board with
12 laps. Together. At this point, Ukraine in the lead.
Romania in second, then the third position for Belarus.
Romania and Belarus next. The fourth team, the Czech Republic, has vanished from the lead lap. Not sure what happened. Didn't see a fall. But clearly they are not in the running with 9 laps to go. The 3,000 meters goes by quickly. We'll see what can happen. Look for the likes of the Elfin to make a push. Guidro for Romania. So much talent here. 7 laps to go. It's crucial here to have the timing down, that you have your last, presumably best skater, and the handoff, the push off is smooth, giving them a chance, if it's tight, to push on to the win. But at this point, still plenty of time to go, 4 laps, in relatively speaking, but it's clearly Romania and the Ukraine going 1-2, which will essentially be 5-6 in the overall.
We have
Three laps. Ukraine has come up. There we go. Keep an eye on this. Two laps to go. There'll be an... There is the bell lap. There'll be no push. Romania trying to hold on, and it looks like, barring a disastrous turn, there we are.
And the finish for Romania.
Romania or Ukraine, well behind. There's a battle for third. So Romania will be fifth in the overall. The best news for all of the athletes is it was a pretty much of a clean skate. Didn't see any major collisions. Something happened to the Czech Republic team early, maybe midway through the race, when they just disappeared. So many bodies to pick through. If you're an official here, to try to dole out penalties, and that's the beauty of replay, you'll be able to see anything that looks like it's uncommon or perhaps problematic. But by now the Czech Republic is already out, and again, I didn't see what happened for most of the second half. It was Romania and the Ukraine battling, and you see the difference, less than a second, and there was a problem for the Czech Republic. Now the A final. This is the best of the best here. The Russian Federation, their team of boys and girls, absolutely loaded, led by Roskosova with two golds and a silver in this individual event. Ivliev with a silver. Samakin worked well the whole week, and Boitsova chased Roskosova around, and she had a medal here. So a very powerful Russian team. The Netherlands can't be counted out. Bozema, Dalrymple, who's medaled here this week. Van Twoot and Van Zulen. Poland, the surprise 1-2 in the women's, the surprise gold medal from Storomowska in the women's final here. There'll be a handful, and Turkey will clearly be the home favorite here at the Yenisher Ice Rink in Erzurum, Turkey, in case you're joining us. And yeah, we are in Turkey, and you'll know it if Serti, Karagol, Özden, and Uzun, the four in the relay, can manage to compete and be there near the end. They will be pushed hard by this partisan crowd. See a lot of the familiar Turkish flags waving, and you'll know it by the sounds as they announce it. The big surprise, Turkey's Karagol earning a silver medal in the men's 1,000-meter short track.
Ladies and gentlemen,
event.
The A final relay.
And here we go. Strap in, this could get crazy. A rather mild B final. But we'll see what happens here, if it's really competitive at the end.
On start position to the team of the Netherlands.
It is the last short track race here at the 13th European Youth Olympic Festival. Erzurum getting high marks from the entire international community here, from venues to transportation, athletes' village, everything.
Go to the start. Red.
Perhaps you could hear the roar for the Turkish team, and away they go. There's Boitsova handing off to Ivliev. Roskosova now will take over.
Polonya'dan Kristengiska.
And no surprise, Poland running away with this. That is a surprise, but keep your eye on the Russian Federation. Plenty of time. But Poland feeding off of the incredible work by Staromowska, winning the 1,000-meter gold. Poland and the Russian Federation, 1-2. The host country will certainly hear it from the crowd if they can get up to compete for a podium position. At this point, it's Poland, the Russian Federation, and Netherlands have joined the fray. Netherlands 2, Russian Federation 3, chasing Poland, and looks like they're running away with it, but plenty of time, only 17 laps to go, although in terms of real time, it's not that long, but a lot of racing left. And stay tuned, as I've been saying, because we've seen results and positioning change literally on the edge of a blade here.
Second position for the team of the Netherlands.
And how crucial the handoffs are. Netherlands, Poland, Russian Federation right there. The host country nowhere in the picture at this point. About to be lapped, and there goes the Netherlands. They're down. So now the host country with a chance to podium. It's just how this race works. Russian Federation and Poland 1-2.
Russia is leading.
Turkey there, but I believe they're a lap down. Those keeping track, having a fun time weeding out the leaders from those lapped. Near disaster there at the top. Russian holds on. And now it's down to 7 laps, and that'll go quickly. Poland and Russia again. And that was the star of 2 of the women's events. Gold medalist right there.
And we are on the way to the last.
Roskozova hands off.
Final.
Now Samakin
with the Russian Federation
pushing.
Continuing in leading position.
The push now for Poland. Can they rally?
3 laps to go.
3 laps. And now it is Boitseva. She'll hand off. And now Ivliev is the anchor leg for the Russian Federation. And a big lead, bell lap, barring some major event here. It'll be the Russian Federation, Poland, and the Netherlands for the gold. The team 3,000-meter mixed. There's your podium. Russian Federation, Poland, Netherlands. The host country got back in it briefly after the fall, but just unable to hold on. Still an incredible week for the Turkish speed skaters, short track speed skaters, led by Karagol with the silver medal in the boys' 1,000 meters.
We have to wait a few moments for the referee's review of the race, so we can give you the result. The official.
It was Poland and the Russian Federation early. Netherlands were right there before a fall. See if we can catch the fall here. There's Dalrymple handing off. Big cluster of athletes right there and losing the edge. And was that a little shove? It could have been a balancing. But the touch to balance happened right at the time that the Dutch girl went into the padding there on the wall. Interesting. Would they bump the Russians down? We'll have to take a look. Officials have a clear idea of what is allowed and what isn't. But in the replay, there's a little bit of contact. And then it appeared that Van Zuylen went into the wall. But nobody over by the replay. Nobody's looking at a replay. It looks like, well, officials are milling a little bit, but looks like that's the final. They've posted it, and there you have it. And here it is, right there. Nah, hard to tell. Looked like that Van Zuylen was losing her edge anyway. Don't know if there was any kind of a touch that helped her into the wall there. Good news is nobody hurt. And looks like the officials are not going to change anything. Here it is again. It's a steadying hand.
For the victory ceremony.
But it just happened to be just at the time that the... Yeah, it's very, very, very iffy. They can't really see whether there's a review going on. It's an event that's it's a team and it's an important event, and that's it. No harm, no foul, and now the teams come out and will honor third, second, and first. And another gold medal.
And ladies and gentlemen, we will start with
for Raskozova.
Presentation for the relay. May we invite the referee and assistant referees, all three, to come forward and to present the flowers to the winners.
Flower ceremony right here.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Multiple medals for Boitsova and Ilyev, and certainly Raskozova.
The team of the Netherlands.
Dominating.
3000 metre ödül töreninde Hollanda üçüncü olmuştur.
And that's Shoshi Dalrymple. Sarah van Zuylen.
They got up to grab third. A game effort by that group. The host country, Turkey, fourth. They were out of it early.
İkinci olan takım Polonya.
Poland pushed the Russian Federation right to the end. Russia just too strong. With Boitsova, Ilyev, Raskozova, and Simakin. There they are. An incredible week all the way around here at the Yenisier Ice Rink.
Represented by Sofia Boitsova.
We've had a wonderful time as we wrap up Olympic Channel's live stream of the 13th European Youth Olympic Festival. Erzurum, Turkey. I'm Tom Kirkland. Hope you enjoyed all of our coverage, live streaming opening ceremonies, the hockey in day one, actually day two of the competition, ski jumping, figure skating, yesterday's boys' alpine slalom, and now the boys and girls 1,000-meter short track speed skating and the 3,000-meter mixed relay. A good time had by all. Hope you enjoyed it. Reminder, you can continue to watch the results and the feedback on our Facebook page. It's available on YouTube. And as the flowers go around, certainly Erzurum can feel very proud of how they presented and executed the 13th European Youth Olympic Festival.
And
Erzurum certainly made
the
European sports community smile as well. Don't forget, later this summer, the summer edition of the European Youth Olympic Festival in Hungary. And next week, beginning actually Sunday with opening ceremonies from Sapporo. Olympic Channel will live stream the Asian Games, which will Asian Winter Games, which will in this event certainly feature many of the Republic of Korea's dominant speed skaters, short track speed skaters. On that note, enjoy the moments as we say goodbye. Olympic Channel's live stream.
And we welcome the youth of Europe.
We've been here all week and back again Sunday from Sapporo with the Asian Winter Games. Tom Kirkland saying thanks. Hope you enjoyed it. So long for now, everybody.
Ladies and gentlemen, have a nice journey home. Let's meet again. Goodbye.
Goodbye. This is Romania.